I'm just doing a sound test before the service starts to make sure everything is working this evening. evening and welcome to you all to Tuesday of Holy Week. I'm hopeful that everything is working online and I can welcome people joining us on Facebook this evening as well. This is the problem with being down here and not up there. I didn't discover there was a major problem with it all until after the service. So hopefully it's now all sorted and that those joining us from home will be fine for this evening. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Jesus said, "Come to me, all who labour and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest." God shows his love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Let us then show our love for him by confessing our sins in penitence and faith. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Collect, our special prayer for this week. Almighty and everlasting God, who in your tender love towards the human race sent your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, to take upon him our flesh and to suffer death upon the cross, grant that we may follow the example of his patience and humility and also be made partakers of his resurrection, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. So would you please be seated for our first reading. Our first reading is taken from the book of Isaiah, chapter 49, verses 1 to 7. Listen to me, O coastlands. Pay attention, you peoples from far away. The Lord called me before I was born. While I was in my mother's womb, he named me. He made my mouth like a sharp sword. In the shadow of his hand, he hid me. He made me a polished arrow. In his quiver, he hid me away. And he said to me, "You are my servant, Israel, in whom I will be glorified." But I said, "I have labored in vain. I have spent my strength for nothing and vanity. Yet surely my cause is with the Lord, and my reward with my God." And now the Lord says, "Who formed me in the womb to be his servant, to bring Jacob back to him, and that Israel might be gathered to him. For I am honored in the sight of the Lord, and my God has become my strength." He says, "It is too light a thing that you should be my servant, to raise up the tribes of Jacob and to restore the survivors of Israel. I will give you as a light to the nations, that my salvation may reach to the end of the earth. Thus says the Lord, the Redeemer of Israel and his Holy One, to one deeply despised, abhorred by the nations, the slave of rulers. Kings shall see and stand up, princes, and they shall prostrate themselves, because of the Lord who is faithful, the Holy One of Israel, who has chosen you." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. So would you please stand for our gospel reading. Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory. Christ humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even death on a cross. Therefore God has highly exalted him and given him the name that is above every name. Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory. Hear the Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. John. Glory to you, O Lord. Now among those who went up to worship at the festival were some Greeks. They came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee, and said to him, Sir, we wish to see Jesus. Philip went and told Andrew. Then Andrew and Philip went and told Jesus. Jesus answered them, The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Very truly I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Those who love their life lose it, and those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there will my servant be also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honour. Now my soul is troubled, and what should I say? Father, save me from this hour. No, it is for this reason that I have come to this hour. Father, glorify your name. Then a voice came from heaven. I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again. The crowd standing there heard it and said that it was thunder. Others said, an angel has spoken to him. Jesus answered, This voice has come for your sake, not for mine. Now is the judgment of this world. Now the ruler of this world will be driven out, and I, when I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all people to myself. He said this to indicate the kind of death he was to die. The crowd answered him, We have heard from the law that the Messiah remains forever. How can you say that the Son of Man must be lifted up? Who is this Son of Man? Jesus said to them, The light is with you for a little longer. Walk while you have the light, so that the darkness may not overtake you. If you walk in the darkness, you do not know where you are going. While you have the light, believe in the light, so that you may become children of light. After Jesus had said this, he departed and hid from them. This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. May I speak in the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. On Facebook, I've recently started to follow the Iona community page. I've been very fortunate that I've been to Iona, the small island off the coast of Mull, twice. And yes, for those of you who know me well, you'll know that this is obviously a very special place because you have to go on not one, but two boats to get there. And as you know, boats are not my favourite things in life. Some of you may have also been fortunate to go to Lindisfarne as well, both places being very much holy places. They are described as being thin places. Places where the gap between heaven and earth is very small. Even watching the services online from Iona Abbey, you can feel that closeness, that being drawn towards Jesus, which is almost tangible when you are on the island itself. I know I sound like the Iona tourist board, but believe me, it is worth the journey. The Greeks, when they come wanting to see Jesus, must have been looking for that thin place, a place where they could closely encounter God, not in a place this time, but in a person. They were on that journey of seeking and searching for something that they thought would be found in Jesus. Interestingly, we're not told if they actually ever meet Jesus, but their arrival triggers a response from Jesus that his hour had come. It was almost as if this was the moment he had been waiting for, the sign that the next stage of his ministry was to begin. He goes on to speak about a grain of wheat having to die before it can bear much fruit, a direct comment on what will happen to Jesus. He had to go to the cross for God's work to flourish. And all this is sealed by God's words to Jesus and the crowd. Holy Week is often a time when we encounter God more directly. It may be through the words and actions of others. It may be when we're not expecting it, that we find ourselves in a thin place, which encourages us on our journey of faith, our continued journey towards God and Jesus. So I'd like to finish with just a very brief poem from the Iona community, which talks about journey, which talks about seeking, and about what we do when we leave our places of worship as well. Pilgrim's journey, where do we find you? Longing for silence, seeking, searching, solitude. Running restful waters, shimmering leaves, whispering wind. Ancient ruins, stories in stones, Celtic crosses standing strong, ancestors remembered. Journeying forth, we leave this sacred place, souls enriched, mystery unfolding, knowing we know. So let us pray. As we gather in the peace and quiet of this place, and in the peace and quiet of our homes, we thank you, Lord, that you call out to us, that in our seeking and searching, you draw us ever closer to you. Through the people we have around us, through the words of scripture that we hear, through the prayers that we are able to make. We thank you that we can meet you in the expected and unexpected places of our world. We thank you that we find you when we seek, and we find you when we're walking away. As we continue our journey this week, as we hear how Jesus recognised that his hour had come, so we thank you that we walk alongside you, Lord, in these steps to the cross. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those in our world who are seeking and searching for peace, who look for what they need in life, those basic necessities that we take for granted. We continue to pray for the troubled areas of our world, particularly for Myanmar, Mozambique, those places which are divided and torn apart by hatred and discrimination. We pray for those who work for peace, who work to bring about care and support for people in our world. And we pray for leaders of nations, that they would have courage at this time to really speak up and speak out where there are problems found, but also to pull together in the fight against this global pandemic we are all facing. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We give thanks for our families and our friends. We pray, Lord, that you dwell within our homes, within our hearts and within our communities. We pray for our town, We pray for our young people, for those on their school holidays and those still in places of education. We ask that you would be with them as they learn and as they seek to be the best people they can be in their lives. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. So we pray for those who are unwell, for those who suffer in body, mind or spirit, and especially for those who care for them, for those working in our hospitals and across the medical profession. We pray especially this evening for those we carry in our hearts and our minds, and also for Noah, Barbara, Sienna, Rosabella, Jeff, Hazel, Len, Emma, Raymond, Derek, Lorraine, Lisa, Annette, Ruth, Emily, Brenda, Rick, Nora, Roy, Margaret, Jeff, David, Alan, Lorraine, John, Elaine, Jim, Sister Catherine, Kath and her family, Steve, Christine, Douglas, Brian, Ian, Joanna, Jean, Jane, Eric, Jennifer, Barbara, Susan, Pauline, baby Thomas and Andrew. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. As we travel through this Holy Week, we focus our minds on the cross, on the death and the resurrection of our Lord Jesus, that by this he won for us the victory over death, brought light back into the world, and open the gate of glory for eternal life. And so we pray for those who have died, for those who died this past day, for those who died recently, for Liz Jones, Gerald Barker, and Francis Maleni, and for those whose anniversaries are this week, for Kitty Rose, Andrea Jackson, Elizabeth Warren, Linda Coughlin, Evelyn Knowles, Mary Bonner, and Jack Buck. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. So I invite you to stand for the peace. Once we were far off, but now in union with Christ Jesus, we have been brought near through the shedding of Christ's blood, for he is our peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. And so we share the peace by waving to one another to create that wave of peace around church and joining with our friends online as well. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For as the time of his passion and resurrection draws near, the whole world is called to acknowledge his hidden majesty. The power of the life-giving cross reveals the judgment that has come upon the world, and the triumph of Christ crucified. He is the victim who dies no more, the Lamb once slain, who lives forever, our advocate in heaven to plead our cause, exalting us there to join with angels and archangels, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, the broken bread and wine outpoured, may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread, gave it to them, and said, Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again he praised you, gave it to them, and said, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. So, Father, remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. Bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation, we proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes, and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favour on your people, gather us in your loving arms, and bring us with St. Peter and all the saints to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ, and with Christ, and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory are yours, O loving Father, for ever and ever. Does our Saviour taught us, so we sit or kneel to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. We say our prayer after communion together. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. Thank you for joining us for our service this evening, either in person or online. It's good to be able to walk through Holy Week with real people this year. I was saying to the cat earlier on, we did all this in the dining room last year, so it's nice to be in church with real people. Tomorrow our service is at 10 o'clock in the morning. There's not an evening service tomorrow, but there will be an evening service on Thursday for Maundy Thursday at 7 o'clock, and then we're back to the morning at 10 o'clock for Good Friday, but you've got a notice sheet probably, so you'll know when our services are this week as we continue this journey together. So I'd like to invite you please to stand as we prepare to receive God's blessing. Christ crucified draw you to himself, to find in him sure ground for faith, firm support for hope, and the assurance of sins forgiven, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you, those you love, and those you prayed for, this night and forevermore. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ.